Hey guys, and welcome back. So in this lecture, we're going to be integrating lead motion with Vuforia to create something really cool. So what we're going to create is a pixel draw in 3D using our camera as well as our lead motion controller. Now, if you don't have a lead motion controller, I suggest you get one. You can get one fairly cheap for around less than $100. So if you have one, you can just follow along with this lecture. But if you do, let's get started. So first of all, we need to download the Leap Motion SDK. So go over to leapmotion.com, and if you scroll down, you can look and see what the Leap Motion is. Now, the Leap Motion controller was used mostly for desktop applications, but for now it has moved more towards virtual reality applications, but we'll use it for augmented reality. Okay, so in order to download the SDK, we first go over to developer.leapmotion.com/get-started. And download the Orion beta download. This will help you to get started with the basics of setting up your device. Now, as you can see here, that the Leap Motion has a whole bracket that can be used with the Oculus Rift as well as the HTC Vive. Now, if you don't have one, don't stress. We are just going to be holding ours up. You can also attach it to a Google Cardboard if you want to. So once you've downloaded that, move over to getting the Unity assets for Leap Motion. So for that, you need to go to developer.leapmotion.com/unity-100. And then you need to download the Unity Core assets. The current version is 4.15. You may have a later version. And once you download that, you can download the detection examples. There are other examples that you can use, but we'll stick with the detection example. This is because our pinch painting example is in this module over here. Okay, so go ahead and download that, and then if you haven't already, make sure you have the correct marker. So in Vuforia, go to Target Manager, click on Tuts, and then make sure you have the stone's target, because that's what we'll be using. You can use the zombie or dragons if you really want to, but for now I suggest using stones because it has a higher rating. Okay, so let's get started. Once you've downloaded everything, import them into Unity. I'm sure you know how to do that by now. If you're not sure how to do that, please refer to my previous videos in the series. Okay, so open up your new project and call it leapmotion_vuforia. We're going to save our scene and make sure you imported the Leap Motion and Leap Motion modules. So for it to work, you need to import Leap Motion first and then Leap Motion modules. And then don't forget our Vuforia asset. So first of all, we're going to go to Leap Motion modules, detection examples, scenes, and pinch draw demo. This should bring up the basic stuff over here. This should bring up the examples. Now what you can do is make sure the scale of your hands are a little bit big. If they're a bit small, then you won't be able to see the hands very clearly. So I put my scale as 4, 4, 4. You can make it as large as you want it, or depending on the field of view of your camera. So this is what you should have at the moment. You can test it out and see that it all works perfectly. You can draw something in mid-air. Okay, so let's take this to augmented reality now. So first of all, what we do is we go to Vuforia, prefabs, put in our AR camera, and then we put in our image dog. Now under AR camera, remember we had our app license key. That you can get over here under License Manager. The website is developer.vuforia.com/target-manager-license-manager-license-listing-details. And then you can paste it into App License Key. Over here, you want to activate your TUTS database as you had before. Make sure it's activated. Go to Image Target. And then under Database, select TUTS. And then we want to select our stones. You can select Zombie or Dragons as we did in a previous lecture. But we'll stick for stones for now, mainly because it has a higher detection rating than the previous ones. So that's more or less what we need to get this thing going. Make sure your webcam is connected, and let's click the play button to see if it works. And as you can see, it works perfectly, though my handwriting doesn't look that great. Now what's really cool is that you can turn this around and you can edit your painting in 3D. If you want to change the color, click pause, go to pinch drawing. Over here you can change the draw radius. So if yours is too small, you can make it 0.02 or make it larger and change your color to red. If you unpause, and then you can draw something right around there. And see how cool that is. Brilliant. Okay, so that's it from me. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next video.